Hey fan, what's up? What's good? I've been meaning to talk about this for a long time. I just haven't gotten around to it because I've had so much else to do. But I saw a video this morning from someone I don't really know all too well. I may have only seen a couple of his videos before, but instantly, with what he had to say, my respect for him just like went through the roof. Because the thing that really got me in his video was that he's not gonna vote against the interests of his own family. He's not gonna vote for someone who's so against women and women's rights, because that's gonna severely affect the lives of his mother, grandmother, sisters, and aunt. And that's the way I look at it too. I would never vote against the rights of anyone. I wouldn't vote against the rights of, you know, half the population, because, you know, I come from a family of all women. You know, I have a mother, grandmother, and an aunt myself. I may not have any siblings, but I do have a mother, a grandmother, and aunt, and I'm not gonna vote against women's rights by voting for a complete, worthless, psychotic, evil piece of shit like Romney. He is just, there's no words for just how much of a piece of shit he is, for real. And I've been holding my tongue for the last few months or so, you know, just out of respect, because I respect that everybody has a right to believe what they want to believe. Everyone has a right to make their own choices and their own decisions, and everybody has a right to vote for who they truly want to vote for. But I've been holding my tongue while I see so many juggalos and so many non-juggalos that are pet owners that I know just in circles of people who rescue animals and whatnot. And I see all these people that are gonna vote for Romney, that are going to vote against their very own interests because they just have some reason to hate Obama so much. And I understand a lot of people hate Obama, you know, from everything from simply for him being black, or they hate him because they truly believe he's not an American citizen, or they hate him because he hasn't done enough to improve their lives directly in these past 4 years, or they hate him because, yeah, he does kind of live more of the celebrity lifestyle. You know, he goes to all these vacations and, you know, special events that have really nothing to do with politics or bettering this country or bettering the world. And he does all this other stuff that he shouldn't be doing, and I agree with that. But overall, my point is that at least with Obama in office, we are still free. We can still live our lives and do what we normally do. And we're not going to have that with Romney. I mean, seriously, Romney is a piece of shit on a whole other level. You know, I came across this Dogs Against Romney site, which talks about his animal cruelty. Because this is way back in like 2008 or some shit. He had a dog that was a senior, like 12 or 13 years old, that he traveled 1,200 miles with the dog strapped to the roof of the car, because that's where he honestly believes animals belong. And this dog was just terrified, absolutely terrified, and that's nothing short of animal abuse and torture. And the dog ended up dying. And he also had a horse, and I don't really know anything about caring for horses, but the horse got a little bit sick or something that would have been easily fixed, but he denied the horse vet care, and the horse ended up dying. So this guy's a piece of shit, just on a whole other level. He hates women, He's going to take away all their rights. You know, women aren't going to be able to see a doctor. They're not going to be able to use any kind of birth control. They're not going to have any rights over what happens to their own bodies. You know, he said all that shit about how you can't get pregnant from rape because the body can shut down. And he's just completely full of nonsensical bullshit. And him and his total dick running mate, Ryan, they both want to put an end to everything. Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, all kinds of welfare and government aid. They're just going to cut it all off. And this is going to put millions upon millions of people out into the streets. Millions of seniors are going to be kicked out of their homes, hospitals, and nursing homes where they're living once they don't have any income to pay their rent or any Medicare to pay for their medical needs. Plus all of the people that are, you know, sick and disabled, they're going to be thrown out onto the streets. And I just think millions, millions and millions and millions of people are going to end up dying because of that. And on top of that, millions upon millions upon millions of people are going to be suddenly homeless, and there's just going to be a flood in the streets of thousands to hundreds of thousands of people, depending on, you know, your population in whatever city or town or area you're in, of people that are suddenly homeless under Romney. And it's just going to be a disaster, and I think that's just totally the wrong choice. I can understand if you're mad at Obama for whatever reason, but seriously, if you're voting for Romney, you're voting against your own interests. You're voting against women. You're voting against the poor. You're voting against the lower middle class, the low wage earners. You're voting against seniors. You're voting against the sick and the disabled. And I just can't wrap my head around how so many people I know are so convinced that Romney is a great choice and they're gonna vote for him. It does my head in. Personally, I plan to vote third party. I know it is a crazy and insane long shot to vote for a third party, because a third party is never going to have a chance to rise up. First of all, you know, you don't even see anything on TV about any other party. When they have the debates on TV and they have the information about the elections and the candidates, they only show Republican and Democrat candidates. I haven't even seen a commercial for any third-party candidates. So I actually hadn't heard of this person except for a few weeks ago when there was an ad on Facebook for it. Yeah, see what I mean? The information's just not out there. So a third-party doesn't have a chance because they've got the whole country locked into only Romney or only Obama, because that's the only people they talk about on TV. It's the only people you'll ever hear about. It's the only people you'll ever see. It's the only people you'll get any news coverage about, and no one knows anything else. So I seen the Facebook ad for Jill Stein. So I clicked on it, looked it up, looked up her page, and pretty much came to the conclusion that, yeah, I liked her and her story, and especially her pick for the vice president is another woman. I'm not even going to pretend that I know how to pronounce her name, because I'm just not good at pronouncing names. But, and what I like about her is that she's a real person with a real story. It doesn't sound to me like she was born filthy rich or anything like that. It says that when she was a kid, she had a brother that committed suicide. She ended up, you know, homeless as a teenage parent herself. And she has worked hard her whole life advocating for the poor and the homeless. And, you know, we need people like this in government. We need real people that know what it's like to have a hard life and have it rough in the world. We don't need these rich millionaires and billionaires born into money that have absolutely no concept whatsoever of the real world. But anyway, I went even further and looked up the Green Party's website to see more about where their issues stand, because I couldn't find all of the information I wanted on her site. So I go to the Green Party's webpage, and I was surprised. I pretty much agree with everything down the line. They're, you know, all for all types of equality, you know, including gender identity. And you see, that's another problem, is people don't look into things like that, because, you know, I really hadn't heard too much about the Green Party except for the jokes everyone makes about them being hippies and crazy and all this other shit. But if you just go to their website and look at their values and where their issues stand, I would be just completely floored if there's a juggalo out there who wouldn't agree with that stuff, who would think that we don't need equality, that we don't need freedom, that we don't need rights, and all of this stuff. Now, I know some people are against big government, and I agree, government shouldn't reach too far, but I think the job of a government is to make sure that everything runs smoothly, to make sure that everyone has a chance in life, regardless of who you are, regardless of your race, religion, country of origin, gender identity, sexuality, or anything else. Because if you leave it up to people to freely discriminate, they will. People are just insanely prejudiced and hateful anymore. It's like society has just really gone backwards in time. You know, we went from, you know, generations before mine that fought for their rights and fought for equality for, you know, women and, you know, black people and other minorities. And society has just gone back on that, you know, tenfold and become the most racist, sexist, prejudiced, hateful, bigoted society. So if you leave it up to people to discriminate against who they hire or who they let live in their building or anything else, they're going to discriminate. So I think the government needs to be just big enough to make sure that things are running smoothly and that everyone has a chance to do what they want to do with their life and make a living. But then I also subscribed to her email list, and it was in one of her emails that points out that there is no coverage on TV of any other party candidates, that the debates that they have on TV purposely exclude everything else because they don't want any other party to rise up. They want everyone to only be for Republican or a Democrat candidate. Because, you know, there's just not much difference in the parties anymore. They're both controlled and manipulated by mega corporations, and they will ultimately do what they are told to do by the billionaires. And so ultimately, we will always have a government that is only serving the ultra-rich, the top 1%. They're never going to show anyone from any other party on TV because the other parties don't feed into the system. They're not corporate sponsored. They don't have the ties to the billionaires, to the top 1%, to the corporation heads that we're talking about, that the Republicans and Democrats do. So it's really, really hard for a third party to have any hope of rising up whatsoever. I mean, if you go to her website, there's a map that shows you what state she's going to be on the ballot for. And it is a long shot because people don't know she exists. People don't know any other candidate exists. They're only going to show the Republican and the Democrat on TV, and they're not going to give even 2 seconds of time in the news to mention another candidate's name. But the point is that if we have any hope at all, any hope, any chance of turning things around, of getting someone in the White House that actually cares about the people, that cares about equality, that cares about creating jobs, that cares about making taxes fair, you know, making the ultra-rich pay their fair share instead of putting all the burden on the poor people. If we want any chance at all of a better future, we have to get the word out, and we have to get a third-party candidate in there, or at least get a significant number of votes for a third party that sends a message that we're tired of the same old shit. We're tired of how things are going. We're tired of losing our rights and freedoms. We're tired of the overstepping of security measures and TSA and all this bullshit that's going down. And we're tired of this increasing police state. And we damn sure don't want to live in a world where women can't work, and can't get health care, and can't vote. You've got to think of your families. You've got to think of your mothers, your sisters, your aunts, your female cousins, your grandmothers, maybe great-grandmothers. You have to think about their interests here. And your grandparents that are on Social Security and Medicare. You've got to think about your friends or anyone else in your family that might be on disability. You've got to think of yourself and question, do you really want to give like 40, 50, 60% in taxes so that billionaires don't have to pay one red cent? You know, you have to think about your own interests, and you have to think about your family's interests, and not vote for a piece of shit like Romney. And as for voting for Obama, if that's the way you want to go, to vote for the lesser of the two evils, then by all means do so, because at least with Obama, we're still free. We can still, you know, live our lives pretty much how we're used to. You know, the whole TSA thing and security thing, you know, that's kind of bullshit, but at least it really hasn't impacted the lives of those who don't fly anywhere. So things are pretty much still as we know it to be. Of course, it's possible that it could get worse, but like Vanity's Angel said in his video, that all of the fear and paranoia surrounding, you know, Obama, you know, supposedly being an Islamic terrorist and all this bullshit, you know, if he hasn't done anything in the past 4 years, then it's quite likely, you know, he doesn't have that agenda in mind, or else he would have, you know, made us all Islam by now. So, yeah. You can drop that argument and just, you know, for the sake of your family and yourself, for fuck's sake, do not vote for Romney. I'm voting for Jill Stein in one way or another. If I see her on the ballot, or if I have to write her in, because I'm tired of the same old shit. I'm tired of, you know, losing our freedoms and not having complete equality in this country, and that's what makes the most sense to me. So, with that said, I'm done for now. Peace out, fam. Whoop, whoop.